And would you believe I still have some of those huge cards laying around? They seemed a lot bigger in the 80s, didn't they?
It's Young People's Week. It's their chance to win money and prizes on Card Sharks. If they play their cards right, they can win this fabulous holiday gift package and a trip to Hawaii and the chance to take home $32,000. And now, the host of Card Sharks, Bob Eubank.
Oh, well, thank you. Hello, everybody. Welcome to Card Sharks. Nice to be with us today. Hey, you see the prizes? Well, not only do we have those wonderful prizes, we have lots of money, and we have some surprises today you're just not going to believe. In fact, we have some surprises all week long you're not going to believe. First of all, it's Young People's Week. We'll meet our Card Sharks in a moment, but right now, let's say hi to the two prettiest ladies in television. Here they are, our dealers on Card Sharks, of Lacey Pemberton and Susanna Williams. Welcome them, please.
Good morning.
Woo! Surprises today.
Yeah.
It's going to get it crowded up here.
Yeah.
So if you'll deal the cards, we'll tell you about the surprises in just a few minutes. But right now, Lonnie and Alice are our two Card Sharks. Let's get them in here. Here they are. Lonnie, how are you today?
I'm fine.
Good.
My name is Lonnie Bostrom. I live in Fountain Valley, California. I go to James Monroe Elementary School. I'm in the sixth grade. Okay. I have one brother named Lance.
Good old Lance.
Yeah,
and yesterday, he guessed a question right on target, and you got $500 for that. Pretty nice. That's the fastest $500 you've ever made, I'll bet you. Alice, aren't you a pretty lady, and welcome back.
Hi, my name is Alice Park. I'm 11 years old. I go to school at West Valley Christian Academy. I'm in the sixth grade, and I have one pretty sister.
One pretty sister. How nice of you to say that. Okay. Lacey Pemberton is our dealer today. Let me tell you where we left off yesterday. We were in the middle of game number one. It's the first player to win two games that wins the championship and goes on to play for the big money and all those prizes and all those wonderful things. So we were ready to ask the fourth and final question in game number one. That means it's sudden death. Someone has to win the game on the next play of the cards. That's where we're going to pick it up right now. Good luck to you, Alice. The question is yours, and here we go. Alice, we surveyed 100 married men, and we asked them, when you leave for work in the morning, is your wife still asleep? How many married men said their wife is still asleep when they leave for work?
Well, when my dad leaves for work, my mom's usually up because she sometimes makes him breakfast and stuff. But I probably wouldn't be awake because I need my sleep and stuff. So I'm going to say around 47.
47 say their wife is still asleep when they leave. Okay, Lonnie, higher or lower than that?
Can you repeat the question?
Sure. How many married men said their wife is still asleep when they leave for work in the morning? She said 47.
Well,
higher or lower?
When my mom, see, she only gets up because I have to go to school, okay? And so,
I mean, if you weren't around, she'd still be sleeping.
Probably,
yeah.
I swear.
Okay.
And my dad usually gets up about 7 o'clock in the morning, and sometimes even earlier when he goes to golf. But there are a lot of working women out there. But I'm still going to go just a little bit higher.
A little bit higher than that, you say. Well, the actual number of married men whose wife is still asleep when they leave is 19 of them. No, not higher. It was lower. Now, Alice playing sudden death. Alice, these are your choices, hon. You can change the 8 and play it out if you goof. Lonnie wins the game, or you can pass it on to Lonnie. He plays off the ace. If he goofs, you win the game. What are you going to do, hon?
I'm going to pass.
You're going to pass it on to Lonnie.
Lower.
Okay, Lonnie, up to you, pal. Here we go.
Lower.
Lower than the ace it is.
Lower
than the 10, yeah.
Higher!
Is it higher? It is.
Lower!
If it's lower, you win the game. No! You do not win the game, and that means that Alice wins the $100 in game number one. Wow! Woo! Okay, congratulations to you, hon.
$100
to you. Most importantly, though, game number one, win the next game, and you're the champion. Just bad luck, man. Woo! We'll be back in just a moment to find out who our champion is going to be on Card Sharks right after this. See you in a moment. Welcome back to Card Sharks, Young People's Week on our show. And we're ready to continue. Now, Alice won the first game. Lacey's got the cards all dealt out. And we're going to play game number two. Lonnie, got to win this game.
Yeah.
And kids, this is an educated guess question, okay? And this question involves a friend of mine. And the friend is Khartoum the Camel. Khartoum, would you please join us? Thank you. Now, Khartoum is a very gentle camel, does not like girls from Chicago, I understand. So, Lacey, be careful. Now, it's a one-hump camel. Dromedary. Boy, I learned that from our producer. Okay, now. This is where my career has gone, folks, right here. Oh, isn't that sweet? Watch it, Khartoum. There we go. Oh, isn't that nice? What a sweetheart. Lonnie, the question's yours. According to Movieland Animals, what is the maximum number of days a camel like Khartoum can be trained to go without water?
I don't really know about this camel. I mean, this camel, I know they ride them in deserts and stuff, but I think they could train them to go without water for 22 days.
22 days. Alice, do you think it would be higher or lower than that, hon?
Well, I don't know about camels, but I know that they can go a long time in the desert without any water or anything. So I'm just going to say a little bit higher, though.
I think it might be higher. Khartoum was making an unusual noise. I want to ask you about that in just a moment. Okay? The maximum number of days a camel can be trained to go without water is, ready for this one, folks? 90 days. 90 days. Isn't that amazing? Wow. Aren't you a pretty one? Aren't you something special, though? Khartoum doesn't bite, does Khartoum? Good. What was the strange little noise?
She's grinding her teeth.
Oh, I do that at night. And I can't go without water for 6 hours. Thanks for joining us, sweetie pie. That's neat. Thank you. Thank you very much. That's Khartoum.
Oh, my God.
Khartoum, will it be higher or lower? What are you doing over here by me? Get over there where you belong. Get over there.
Is that even my girl?
Ah, that's special. Okay, here we go. Alice, you have control, and here's your first card. It's a 10. You want a player change?
Change that card.
Change that card, we will. The 10 now becomes a 6.
I'm going to go higher.
Higher than the 6. It is.
I'm going to go lower.
Lower than the 9. No. Lonnie gets a free chance at the cards. All right, Lonnie can't change it. There's your card.
Higher.
Higher than the 3. Got it.
Lower.
Lower than the 9. Yes.
Higher.
Is it? Yes.
Lower.
In order to tie it up, we'll play tiebreaker. Yeah. Yeah. Okay. Now, we've got a game for each one of our contestants. This is fun. We're going to have wonderful surprises for you all week long, so stick around. We're going to have a good time this week. Now, tiebreaker, each contestant has one game. That means that we're going to set up for a tiebreaker game with a maximum of 3 cards and 3 high-low questions. Winner of this game goes on to play for all the money in that wonderful holiday surprise package. So, Alice, first question is yours. Lacey and Susanna will deal out the cards, and here we go. We surveyed 100 bachelors. We asked them, are you attracted to chubby girls? How many bachelors said they are?
Well, I don't think men would like chubby girls. They probably want, like, skinny, you know, beautiful women. I don't want chubby little fat things, you know. But they probably, you know, some people, if they were fat, they probably want somebody fat, too. So I'm just going to say it's probably a low number, like 31.
31 out of 100 bachelors say they're attracted to chubby little girls, okay?
Well, Lonnie? I think bachelors want girls like Lacey here. I mean, they want nice girls like Lacey. And I don't think they want fat girls that, you know, aren't going to be able to walk and just want to have...
Have you seen Lace walk?
Well, yeah, but that doesn't count. But I think they want even to be lower because I think they want skinny women.
Okay, you think it's lower than 31. The actual number of bachelors who are attracted to chubby girls is... 13 of them. Yeah, you're right. It was lower. Okay. You got him fooled, haven't you? Yeah, you like Lonnie, don't you? All right, Lonnie, here we go. Here's your first card, pal. It's an 8.
Change the card.
Yeah, we will. The 8 becomes a 3.
Higher!
Higher than the 3. No. Wow. Woo! Okay, Alice is applauding over there. Alice, there for you is a 7, hon.
Higher.
Higher than the 7? No, it is not. Now, Lonnie's applauding. You guys are something. We'll be back in just a moment to find out who our champion is going to be on Card Sharks right after this.
there. I'm Bob Eubanks, and you're watching Buzzer. Let's play.
Welcome back to Card Sharks Young People's Week in our show. You surprised me. I was standing here thinking about other things. Hey, I want to remind everybody that winners of less than $2,500 receive cash. Winners of $2,500 or more will receive certificates of deposit that will mature when they become 18 years of age. We're in a tiebreaker game to find out who our champion is going to be. We have a wonderful, wonderful list of prizes and a lot of money for our champion. So let's go. Next question now involves 10 women who are moms. They're in our studio audience. They're going to help us all week long. So ladies, please join us. There they are, 10 very pretty moms. And Lonnie, the question is yours. Before the show, Lonnie, we asked these 10 moms, have any of your children told you that you're too square? How many of these 10 moms said their child has told them they were too square?
Well, look at these moms. They all look, you know, it's just like regular moms. Well, they are regular moms, but that's...
Just like regular moms. They sleep in.
Yeah. And I would only say about... Three of them look square. I mean, think the children are square.
Three of them. Let's see. Alice, do you think it'd be higher or lower than that?
Well, if I look at these moms, they just look regular to me, too. They don't look square at all.
There are no irregular moms down there, are there?
Yeah. No. But I'm just going to say lower.
Even lower? Well, the actual number of these moms whose child has told them they're too square is three of them. Yeah. The rich get richer. Lonnie wins again. $100 for you this time, pal. $100 is split with our moms down there. I can't imagine. Which three of you moms have been told you're too square? Raise your hand for me, please, ladies. Really? Come on. Nancy, how could you be square now? You're a young, pretty lady.
I have a 14-year-old daughter that walks into the room when I have the radio on and says, oh, it's like walking into an elevator. And she wants me to change my clothes and kind of wear my hair green and spiked.
Oh, good, good. You do that, but don't come around here, okay? Thank you, ladies. It's going to be fun having you with us. All right. Lonnie, I assume you want to keep that three.
I want to go higher, Bob.
Higher than the three, it is.
Higher, Bob.
Okay, if it's higher, you're the champ. You'll play for the big money in that wonderful holiday package. Is it higher than the seven? No. Alice with a free chance off to seven. Alice, here we go, hon.
Higher.
Higher than the seven. Nope, not higher than the seven. Once again, we're going to sudden death, third and final question. That means someone has to win the game and the championship this time. Alice, the question is yours, and here we go. We surveyed 100 men. We asked them, if you were barbecuing hamburgers, I love this question. If you were barbecuing hamburgers for dinner guests and you discovered your dog licking one of the hamburger patties, would you serve it to your guests anyway? How many men said they would serve it to their guest anyway?
Well, if it was like an important client, they probably wouldn't because they would get fired or something. But if it was just like a neighbor or something and they don't want to make any...
Pick the hair out of that sucker and go on, right?
They don't want to make any more.
So, you bet.
So I'm just going to say it's probably around 38.
38 would serve it anyway. Is that what you're telling me? Okay, Lonnie, higher or lower?
My dad he cooks hamburgers, and he's dropped it on the ground, and he's washed it off and gave it to us, and it wasn't that great. But, you know, if they're just neighbors,
sure.
I think that they're not going to serve it to him, because you could tell, because they usually have to wash it off.
How many would serve it, though? Higher or lower than 38?
Under the lower.
Lower than 38? Shoot, I'd pick that little thing up, wash it off, pick the hair out of it, and say, here, George, you'll love it. Actual number of men who would serve the hamburger patty to their guest is 23. You're right, Lonnie, was lower. Okay, Lonnie, it's sudden death. Your choices are as follows. You can play it out. If you goof, she wins the game. Pass it on to her. She must play with a seven. If she goofs, you win the game and the match, too. Big choice for you, pal.
I'm going to play.
You're going to play?
I'm going to go higher.
Okay, he's going to take his fate in his own hands. Higher than the three. Yes, sir.
Lower!
If it's lower, he's the new champ. He is. There you are. You did it, Lonnie. Alice, you end up with $100. We have some nice $700, don't you? Yeah, no, $100. Alice got $100. We have some nice prizes for you, and thank you very much for being with us, okay? Bye-bye, hon. Here you go, Lonnie. Yeah, I was thinking that she'd won the money. You won all that money over there, didn't you? Yeah. Okay. Now, Lonnie's our champion in a moment. We're going to give him a chance to win a whole lot of money, plus some wonderful prizes, including a trip to Hawaii. Be right back for that. Welcome back to Card Sharks. Lonnie is our champion. He now has a chance to win a whole lot of money. In fact, up to $32,000. Plus, we've got some prizes that you just won't believe. And as you know, in addition to all the money you can win, we've added a couple of jokers, Lonnie, to that deck over there. Every time a joker pops up, that gives you another chance of winning that wonderful holiday package, which today includes some great things, such as a computer, a sailboat, keyboard, pool table, bicycles, VCR, and also a trip for four to Hawaii. Hey? And because you are the champ, Lacey's got two jokers for you. That means you'll have two opportunities of winning that wonderful holiday package. Why don't we get your mom in here? Mom, why don't you come in here and join us? This is the lady that sleeps in, right? Okay, Mom, you just kind of help him out if he needs it. We're going to give you $200 to bet with, and we are on our way. Good luck to you, pal. Let's get him now. Here we go. With $200, your first card happens to be a jack.
$100 lower.
$100 lower than the jack. 10's your card. You can play or change, Lonnie.
I'll change with number three.
Number three. He's got $300 right now, and the 10 turns into a queen. That's a better card.
$200 lower.
Going 200, lower than the queen. $500, Lonnie.
$300 higher.
$300, higher than the five. Yes, sir. $800 up here, give you another four. You got $1,200.
$900 lower.
$900 lower than the queen. It is. There you go, $2,100.
Number one.
He knows how to play the game. The nine is a five. With $2,100, Lonnie.
$1,500 higher.
Woo! $1,500. That makes Mom perspire, doesn't it? $1,500 higher than the five. No. Brings you back down to $600. Okay, you can still win some money.
All of it higher.
Yeah, let's go for it. Is it higher? It is. $1,200. Queen's the card. What are you going to do, big guy? Got to bet at least six of it.
All of it lower!
Oh, boy. Step up and meet him. Here we go. All of it lower than the queen. It is! $2,400 in cash. Congratulations to you. Mom, why don't you stand right here? Lonnie, you come right over here with me. You now have won $3,200 in cash. Woo! Doing just fine. Well, not luck. Only that, pal. Over here, Susanna has seven numbered cards. Thank you, Lacey, for the joker. Behind one of those cards is the word win. If you can find it, you're going to win a wonderful holiday package, including that trip for four to Hawaii. Gene, tell them about it, please.
Okay, Bob, a trip for four round-trip coach from Los Angeles to Honolulu. From pleasant Hawaiian holidays, a fabulous week in famous Waikiki, including air transportation and luxury accommodations. Enjoy a pleasant Hawaiian vacation from pleasant Hawaiian holidays.
Thank you, Gene. Okay, guy. This is it. Now, you've already won $3,200 in cash. That's yours no matter what happens. Now, go over there and win all of those wonderful prizes in that trip for Hawaii. Put it wherever you think it's going to be. Joker side out, Lonnie. Number three and number six. All right, he's made his decision. Let's see. If the word win is behind one of those cards, you win all of those prizes plus the trip for four to Hawaii. Come on, we're rooting for you. Is it behind number three? Nope, not there. Well, let's try it again. Is it behind number six? We'll find out now. Is it behind number six? No. Not there. It was down behind number one today, Lonnie. It was right there. It's okay. You did win all of those prizes. Tell you what we have for you. We have another wonderful prize for you. Gene, what else have you got?
Hitachi's 19-inch color TV, electronic fine tuning with remote control, solid-state video and signal tracker systems, cabinet design for beauty and durability from Hitachi.
So you've got the television set, you've got $3,810 in cash, and thank you very much. Have a happy holiday season, Lonnie. Bye-bye, Mom. Thank you, guys. We'll see you next time. Okay, bye-bye, honey. See ya. All right, there goes our champion. Now, we're going to meet two new Card Sharks on Young People's Week, and they're on their way right now. Here we go. Well, look at here. How are you guys?
Good.
You're Hello. Jeff Puna.
Yes. Hello, my name is Jeff Hassay. I'm from Fountain Valley, California. I'm 12 years old. I have two older teenage brothers, and I'm currently attending Fulton Middle School, and I'm in the sixth grade.
Well, okay, Jeff, nice to have you with us. Is it Cheryl Lee?
Yes.
That's your pretty name.
Thank you. Hello, my name is Cheryl Lee Azone. I'm 13 years old. I'm in the seventh grade. I'm an only child, and I'm from Maryville, Tennessee.
Yes, you sure are, yeah. It's fun being an only child, isn't it? Okay, win two games and you're the champ. Lacey's got the cards all dealt out, and here we go. First question goes to you, Jeff. And Jeff, we surveyed 100 women over the age of 65. Over the age of 65. We asked them, in the past year, have you worn a bikini? How many senior citizen women said they have worn a bikini in the past year, Jeff?
Well, my grandmother, like, she's 80, but still. Bikini, she doesn't like to wear stuff like that. She likes to wear warm and comfortable stuff. And she I don't think she'd be able to find a bikini that would fit her.
Oh. And, sorry to hear that.
And
how many out of 100 said they have?
I'll say probably about 25.
25, Shirley?
I know that my grandmother would not wear a bikini because she didn't like to swim and she didn't like bikinis. So
yeah.
I say that number is going to be a little bit higher.
A little bit higher that have worn a bikini?
Yes.
Okay. The actual number of senior citizen women who have worn a bikini this year is 6 of them. 6 of them. Wasn't higher. No, here we go. I can't imagine any of them. I think that's funny. All right, Jeff, there's a 6. One player change.
Change
it. Stacy's got a new card. How about a 6 again then? Can I go higher than the 6? Yeah, it is.
Lower.
No, not lower. Sara Lee, you get a free chance at the cards. My love, here's your first card. It's a jack.
Lower
than the jack. 5.
Higher.
Is it higher? Yeah.
Freeze.
Sure. She'll freeze right there. Okay, protect that lead she's got. We'll pause for these words and we'll be right back with more card sharks right after this.
Up next, it's the Match Game Hollywood Squares Hour, the longest game show title ever, followed by Classic Concentration, the second longest game show title ever. Stay tuned.
Today. We'll see you next time on Card Sharks. Bye-bye.
Some of our young Card Sharks will receive True Value True Test Easy Care Paint for easy dust and painting in 3 finishes and many decorator colors from True Value Hardware Stores. Sun-Made Fruit Fits, a delicious snack with a natural goodness of real fruit. Enjoy a tempting fruit snack from Sun-Made. Swanson Homestyle Recipe Entrees, conveniently microwave in 10 minutes or less for quality and value. Count on Swanson. Be creative with Handicrafts, another great way to use Handy Wipes, America's favorite reusable cleaning cloth. Contact Nighttime Cold Medicine, effective relief with a taste preferred 2-to-1 over the leading nighttime liquid cold formula. Shield Deodorant Soap, it keeps you feeling fresh and clean all day long. Feel fresh the whole day through with Shield. Lasonic's portable AM/FM shortwave micro component system features unique 6 speaker system, 1 touch recording, and 5 watts per channel from Lasonic. And the member of our studio audience will receive Frigidaire Skinny Mini Laundry Center, a family size washer and dryer in 1 compact cabinet with variable Watermizer control and flowing heat drying system from Frigidaire Appliances. This is Gene Wood speaking for Card Sharks, a Mark Goodson television production.
Hi, Buzzer fans. Hey, there's another one of my favorite Match Game Hollywood Squares hours.